Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Exotic Matter, and as you can see it's fairly dark outside, but we're not going that far right now, so that should be okay. I just want to get up to that thing up there, and let's just put this, and then we are gonna head up. Just be a little careful. You can see it's pretty deep down, and well, you can actually take the water as blocks, as you can see, which is a good thing to know, because if you jump into this water, you are kind of stuck. you can't jump up again if you fall into the water, and that means it's a good idea to just try and shoot it and remove it so you land on a block underneath the water, unless it's very deep. I can't see how deep this is, so I don't want to jump in. And then you can actually make your way out again. Just a little tip. What kind of puzzled me in the beginning. So let's go over here. Let's break. Come on, break you. And yeah, with this drill, it's only a basic drill. That's why it said we would like to get a better one. Because it you can't break these. As you can see, these that looks like, I always think they look like dragon scale. But you can't break them with this one. You can break this one, and you can break that white and blue block and the water. And that is more or less it for the blocks that are out here. And then the trees, as you can see out there in the distance, we'll get to those. But right now, wasn't there, I thought there was another way around. To get up here, but okay, I guess we'll just build a staircase. So let's do this, and actually do it from over here. Why not? So let's do this. But oh, come on, falling down. And yeah, I don't know if you guys heard that, but we have company. Yep. We will get to those dudes. Yeah, there's one jumping around over there in the dark. But they are not aggressive. Not those anyways. But it's nice to actually see some life in the game now. Because when I played this game like 6 months ago, there hadn't been any NPCs added yet. So that is very cool. Then the world doesn't seem quite as empty. Okay, so now we have one of these antennae, as you can see. And let's just start with checking this. We have some electronic boards, we got some silver, nice, and we got a blueprint for a power cell, so we can make our own power cells. But hopefully we're also going to find some power cells, otherwise we're just going to have to make some. And then when you get to these, there you can kind of click on this, and you get a little bit of story here too. Signal detected, waypoint added, report to solar. Okay, so Lloyd Hamilton wrote something here. The gravitational disturbances that threw us into Exilent's crust aren't limited to an interplanetary space, apparently. Our in-atmo transmissions reach barely any distance, like they're being refracted into the ground. I've set up these repeater antenna stations around the peninsula so we can communicate over longer distances. Ah, okay, I hadn't actually noticed when it makes that sound. It's in your lower left corner. There's a little pop-up that says map updated. Okay. The repeater antenna stations will also constantly run sweeps for any new signals or transmissions. We need to check these periodically. If they find anything interesting, report back to Solar immediately. Ah, so we have to go back and check them? The new signals will appear at the top of the log. Oh, okay, so we'll have to sometimes go back and check these. Interesting. Well, you can see we now have this one, of course, and we have 2, 3, 4, and 5. But we are going to get back to that. For now, I just want to go in and finish off the house, or the ship, exploring the ship. What's this way I got down? Let's jump, and there we go. Let's get back over here. Try and see if we can avoid falling into a big hole somewhere. There we go. Nice. I am pretty impressed by how fluently it is to move around, actually, in this game. I do play a lot of these voxel-based games, and I must say it is very fluent when you jump around, and, you know, this, like, almost falling off, which in the beginning kind of confused me a little bit, but it actually makes it kind of very fluid. You know, you can see I kind of slowly slide off, and it can often save your life when you're about to fall off. Then you can still kind of make it by quickly stepping back. Which gives this feeling like in real life, if you're about to lose your balance, then you can still kind of save the situation. I kind of really like that. Okay, so what haven't we done in here yet? Well, first of all, I want to see if we what we need for the blue for this power cell here. Okay, we're gonna need silicon for that, but we can get that outside actually, and electronic boards. Then we can make our own power cell. We will get to that. For now, let's just kind of finish everything off here. Is there anything behind you? No, I didn't really expect that to be, and this is only one. Usually it's if there's two of these next to each other, then there might be a chance that there's something there. We already checked that in here because this is where we found this thing. Did we get upstairs yet? I don't think we went upstairs after we got this drill, so let's just go up and check. Because I feel like there was something up there that we could break. Yeah, over here, let's just check if there's anything. Aha! There is actually something behind us. Nice. Okay. Ignimbrite. Okay, got more of that. Then we got some credits. Okay, and a blue grenade. Ooh, yes. That might come in handy later. Then we can actually break a lot of blocks at a time. Or kind of, you can break into stuff with it if you want to. Of course, you have to consider what you destroy in the process. But you can. Okay, so one there, one there, one there. Yep. And... Then we were here. That this way? No, that's this way, wasn't it? Where we couldn't... No, it wasn't in here. Oh, any breakable? Well, there's this stuff, actually, that you can break and get a whole lot of resources from them. Nice. Don't think we're really gonna need you in here anymore. As far as I know, resources are not gonna respawn. Well, I don't know if that's gonna change, but it doesn't seem like they do at the moment. Okay, so I suddenly got a whole lot of these frequency chips. We're gonna have to figure out emits radio signals on a range of frequencies, plug one of these into a transmitter object and one into a receiver to connect the two devices. May have unexpected effects. I haven't tried playing around with these, so I'm not sure how that works. Radio signals? I don't know if that would work with the... we need a transmitter of some kind. Short range command... I'm not sure. That is what you use to add or remove frequency chips. Okay, what would be a transmitter? And one into a receiver? Oh, I don't know if they would work on the antennas or on some of the terminals, but that's something we're gonna look into more later. Let's just kind of finish off this place. So let's head upstairs again. And oh, there's actually, can I break here? Yes. I'm just kind of collecting these mostly for fun. But which reminds me, actually, because it takes there's not that much storage by the main entrance to this building. So I kind of realized last time that it's often just easier to enter right here because you have all these storages right around here, and where we started out is right over here. In this room where you have, you know, a nice amount of storage kind of close together. So I was thinking for now I want to kind of use this, I think. So I'm just gonna move these over here. And yeah, for those wondering, there's no way currently to like shift click, control click, right click or something to make them pop into here. So that's why I'm just sitting here dragging them. If you want to empty all of this, like in one go, you can click over here, or you can just click, I think it's E or R or something. I'm not going to do it because they're all going to pop in here. I did that during the live stream, but I hope that that is something that's going to change in the future. It's ship hard-coded with a program. If I build a server, I can plug in and run the program. Yeah, we're going to get to that. Let's put these memory chips down here. And for now, well, we do have some blueprints. We have a bigger one. Yeah, let's put the blueprints in here. So we have a blueprints for power cell, for the emergency drilling. Actually, I might want to keep this on me because we're going to do this later. Electronics boards, shelter wall. Well, we have electronics boards here, so we don't really need the blueprint right now. Awesome. Okay, let's keep going. And oh, what about you? So I think this just leads. Okay, that's the outer wall. Nothing there. Okay, so let's get back up and if we can find that spot where there was another, we needed another access card. That was true here, right? Or no, it wasn't true here. Oh, it was over here. Okay, anything we can destroy? Well, we can destroy that, but nope, that's not gonna help. Okay, let's get our access card and left click. There we go, nice. And then we can open this. Gives me a blueprint for a class 2 drilling laser. Oh yes, I want this one. I haven't tried having that one yet, but I hopefully we're gonna get around to that. We've got actually some shelter wall pieces here and some more blue grenades, but yeah, I definitely want to work towards getting one of those. So there we go, look at this, we are actually outside. Yeah, so from here you can kind of head out to explore. Tried some of the Bulbo's tough-skinned fruit native to Exilin. I dubbed it the teal nut. Thanks to my current state of borderline starvation, it tasted just like HeroCorp's Vitae pie. I wonder if do-it-yourself Vitae is possible. That would be invaluable. I'm a psychologist, not a chemist, but I managed it. Take two pieces of teal nut and add some water. Voila. Oh, voila. A homemade Vitae. There could be a market for teal nut Vitae back on Earth. Aha. If it's still there when I return. Yeah, that's a question. If I return. Okay, so we did find the duct tape recipe. We did find the Vitae recipe and the teal nut recipe. There's one for battery too. I must have passed that by somewhere. And let's break these. Get ourselves some resources. I have no idea if this stuff has any function. That's when they're sitting there, but I think it's just a way to get some more resources. Okay. Why can I suddenly not open that door? That's something new. Okay. It's broken! I can't get back in. Usually you can. Just click here and it will open. Okay. That seems to be broken, so let's just try and go around then. There we go, let's get up here. And we can break this for more ignimbrite. Okay, you can see there is the first of these antennas. What else can we see out here? We have the kind of almost like a big ocean piece here. So if we wanted to go to IS2 first, that would be over there. Not that I think you have to go to them in a specific order, but okay, let's jump down here and see if we can jump there without getting ourselves hurt. Nice, we made it back down. And I'm pretty sure we didn't get the recipe for the battery in this round, so I must have skipped something. That's the problem when you play the game again, after just having played through this, because I can't remember what I did in this one and what I did in the previous few episodes. We were in there. Did we check this one? I don't think we have read this one. I could use Sandra's hands here. Watching her program a replicator was like seeing real magic being performed before your eyes. Thus far, the best I've managed was a working battery. This is what I was looking for. Combined two teal nuts and some silicon to print one of those. Nice. If Sandra were around, she'd conjure a reactor while single-handedly beating me at Savon. Okay. Cool. There was actually a little room in here too. I don't think I found that last time. Okay. Oh, nice. 20 silver. Okay. Interesting. Oh, what is this? Okay. Yeah, I don't think we can break that one. Can we break any of it from the... Just because I'm curious. We can get free resources. That is always welcome. Okay, well, I think we got around to all the different resources now. Or the different recipes. Okay. There we go. We got this. And... Did we go in here? Okay, that's where the elevator was down. Awesome. Well, I think we are gonna go, and then it just leads out. Yeah, I think we're gonna go down to the replicator and try and see if we can actually craft some stuff. So, if we go in here, we are gonna need... where is it? A blueprint emergency drilling laser, because I want to make a Tilna cannon. So, we are gonna need 3 batteries. Okay, so... Let's do this. In a battery, we need 2 teal nuts and some silicon. So we are gonna have to go outside, actually. And see if we can find some teal nuts. We just need to find some trees. Okay, what would be the fastest way to find trees? Over there, maybe? Try and go, whoop, go around. Whoop, jump, up, up, up. And... Actually, I also want to spray some of this. Go. Because that's gonna give us some resources. For instance, some silicon, which we are gonna need too. So, there we go. Give me those. Thank you. Okay, so let's see. What did we get? Got 8 silicon. Okay, that's the beginning. Okay, that might not have been the best way around. Okay, we can go this way. Ooh. Ooh, whoop. There we go. And then there's these little dudes. And you can kill them with a teal nut cannon if you want to. But they are not aggressive. So, and so far it doesn't seem like any of the mobs in the game drops any loot or anything. So I don't see the point in killing them. Ooh, at this point. Ooh, give me this. Thank you. Got some leaves. There we go. And some teal nuts. Nice. Do, 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 do. Oh, give me those. And you have to kind of pick them up fairly soon because they are gonna despawn if you just leave them on the ground. Okay, let's try and go up here. Whee! And there's some grass which doesn't seem to give you anything if you destroy it. Aha! Oh! I actually made it. Over to IS-5. Well, we might check that out since we're here anyway. Let's try and get a little bit more. We are gonna need more of these teal nuts later because they are... We need them to make the batteries and we can make vitae. Was that out of that too? No, let's see. Yeah, 2 teal nuts and water we can make vitae with 2 teal nuts and silicon, which we got from these white blocks. We can make batteries out of the leaves that we just got. We can make duct tape. And then, of course, we are gonna need we are gonna need teal nuts as ammunition for later. So let's just get a little bit more silicon, actually. up here. And yeah, it doesn't seem to have any, like, what is the world? Doesn't seem to be an a battery or anything on this one that runs out or anything. You can just kind of use it endlessly. There's no limitation, it seems. I could find out what I'm trying to say. There we go. Get these. And, of course, you also get some sand from it. But yeah, we have 22 silicon now. Okay, well, that should be good enough for right now. So, let's just go down here and check this out since we are over here anyway. Ooh, nice. Look at this. You get some really nice stuff, so it's a really good idea to go to these. Okay, blueprint for a server. Okay, what was it we needed the server for? That was for the memory chips. A chip hard-coded with a program if I build a server. Yep, so we're gonna need that. Then there's blueprint for these memory chips, actually. Blueprint for a flip-flop, which I'm still wondering what it is, but apparently something computer-related. And then there's a button. Yep, nice. Thank you. Where's the thingy? Whoa! Oh, yep, that happens when you forget to keep an eye on where you're walking. Lucky me that it wasn't any deeper than it was. Okay, let's just build ourselves a little staircase. There we go. Nice, we can get back up. Awesome. And, oh, come on, careful. Yeah, it's just, and there's the strangest light all the time in the game. It's very fascinating, actually, to just stand and look at the sky as it changes. The night sky is gorgeous. Like, the colors are so gorgeous. Okay. So, through the winter. Okay. Studying this world is like trying to build a coherent image by looking through a kaleidoscope. One collects naught but jigsaw pieces and upside-down fragments. Oddity the First. Smith and I observed some water anomalies near the ship. Ballooning, spiraling portions of water above the surface, elongating up and then pirouetting like a spinning top. Was it caused by some kind of organism or technology beneath the surface? If the fluid itself is even water, did it create this motion autonomously? Oddity the Second. Smith and I were down in the Criterion's lower deck sifting through components when we heard the squelching, as Smith put it, a series of smacks and slurps on the other side of the hull. From within Exilin's earthly bowels. I thought it might have been some subterranean fauna, a worm or mole analog, but there was no sound of shifting earth. Just the sound of jelly being pressed through a tight space. Terribly odd. Yeah. Okay. So that is interesting. I haven't seen any water anomalies. I don't know if it's something we're gonna see. At least not that I've noticed. Well, I haven't noticed them anyway, so. But I haven't seen anything. And I don't know if it means that we're gonna run into something down in the darkness somewhere. But yeah, as you can see, it also gets very, very dark in the game. So, at the moment, it is, a little hard going mining or going spelunking a little below. It's fairly okay as long as you're here on the surface, because this gorgeous night sky, look at that, actually provides a decent amount of light to move around. And we do have these blocks here that we can put down, just like the ones we find in the ship, like those. But it doesn't help you much if you're on the move, because then you'll be out of the reach of the light so fast. But There is gonna be a portable light at some point. It was intended to be added and it hasn't, it just hasn't been added yet. But that is gonna be awesome when that happens. I would love to be able to make a flashlight or something that you could use. Well, preferably I would love to have one that you could put on the drill, so that when you carry the drill around, or if you go mining, then you don't have to switch between. Or if it was like a, you know, like a mining helmet type of thing, so you have it on your head all the time. That would also be cool. But preferably something that doesn't cause you to have to switch between your drill and the light. But we'll have to see what happens. So, how much do I have? I have 57 tinlots. I'm gonna have to grind some more before we start heading anywhere else. Let's see. Yeah, we have an observatory up here, as you can see. And this is where we're gonna need a bunch of tinlots. Oh, yeah, okay. So we have RS2, RS3, RS4, but first of all we need to head home. And let's actually see, if we go in here, what can we can make batteries. If we take some teal nuts and some silicon, we needed batteries. We needed, was it 3 batteries or something? So you just kind of take this, move it up, 2 and 3. That would cut it for making one of these. But let's just make a couple of extra ones. Why not? There we go. Now we have 5. And what else do we have to make? Then we could make duct tape. So if we take you, we can take this down here. And then you just kind of pull it out. There we go. Nice. We can make some extra duct tape. We already have some, so I don't really need to make any more right now. Then we could make vitae, 2 teal nuts and water. We have a little bit of water here. And we have some teal nuts. There we go. See, then we can make another VJ can. Let's just make these 2. We can make nice. And then, of course, there's the teal nut cannon, where we're gonna need to make another one of those. I don't want to use this until we actually have this thing, because we need this to grind resources. So I want to make a new one, so we have one, before I make this teal nut cannon. But for that, we're gonna need the VJ cans. We do have those. We need duct tape. We have that. And then we need a power cell, which we actually haven't found yet, have we? But we do have a blueprint. We had a blueprint for it. We have a blueprint in storage. Emergency drilling laser. So, I'm fairly certain you get some power cells, actually, if you go exploring the other antennas. You get some nice, it's a really good idea to get that, because, or you get some story, and of course you get some resources from each of them, which is very, very important to go and get. So we are gonna go do that, but I want to see if I can make a power cell. Am I going the right way? Yeah, home is there. It's fairly dark. There we go, jump over here, nice, and we are, ooh, almost there. Cool. Okay, so let's just go in here and get our recipe for the power cell, which I probably left in here. Let's see, what do we have? Shelter wall, electronic board, yes, the power cell. So let's take you. Then we have a button. I don't need a button right now. Flip-flop, I have no idea what a flip-flop is. Emergency drilling laser, yes, we're gonna need that. Blueprint memory chip, no, don't think I need to make that yet. I want to see how to make a server in this class 2. I don't think we have the resources for that yet, but hopefully we will later. Okay, so then we go over here to our replicator. Aha, and let's see, power cell, start with you. Can I make this? Oh, think, was it battery and something we needed? No, okay, silicon and electronic boards. Well, it's a good thing we got the silicon and we got the electronic boards, and then we just say replicate an empty general purpose power cell. The only thing that this thing needs to be useful is some energy. Okay, nice, we got a power cell. Aha, and then we need yeah, then your recipe just, or your blueprint pops back in here. Okay, blueprint, emergency drilling laser. We need batteries and electronic boards for this. A standard issue UNSN machining tool. In this case, a low power laser that can cut through soft materials. Would come in handy in emergencies. Emergencies like this. Yep, let's make one of those. Picked up. Awesome. And we got our blueprint back here. And we got this extra emergency drilling laser. Okay, so let's go in here. We are gonna need this. We need the emergency drill. Let's put you here. We need the power cell. Put you down here. We need the Vita can. We're gonna put you here. And then we needed the duct tape. Oh, come on. Just place you right there. Look at this. Teal nut cannon. A handcrafted cannon that can shoot teal nuts. Hey, hey, nice. So now we have one of those. That is awesome. Yep, I love this little BB gun. I don't know why I call it a BB gun, but I do. But yeah, now we have a weapon, actually. That is cool. So we don't need these right now, but let's just check out what the other things cost. If I wanted to make a server. This marvelous piece of technology can control a multitude of devices. Use your XCOM to program it. It requires a memory chip to work. Okay, so it takes sand, which we have, silver. Okay, we're just gonna make one. I don't think I'm gonna place it down right now. But then we have it. Well, we could try and place it down, but I'm not sure if where I want to place it down. But now we have one. So that is what we need the SCOM for. The SCOM we have right here. Cool. And we do have some memory chips. We are gonna look at this in a little bit later. Then we have the class 2 drilling laser. What am I missing? I am missing uranium. Okay, well, I haven't found any of this or seen any of this. A very rare natural element and one with potent nuclear properties. Even if it sometimes needs to be transmuted, could be very useful in reactors. I don't know if you I would assume we can find this when we go mining underground. But on the other hand, I'm thinking that can't really be it. Well, unless we can actually mine this with this one. Well, I guess we'll have to, because otherwise we can't actually make the better one. So I have no idea where to find this, but we'll just have to see if we can locate it at some point. Okay, so we have this, and yeah, with the BB gun, you just use the teal nuts that you have, so you just kind of left click, look at that, then you can shoot. Yeah, so I have to go and grind some more teal nuts before we head to the observatory. But we got a little bit of crafting done. We checked out one of the antennae, and we are gonna go and next time we're gonna go and check out some of the other ones, and after we have done all of that, of course, we're gonna go back to the observatory. So thank you for watching, guys, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.